So today I'm going to talk to you about the 5 secrets of a happy retirement. Coming up next. Hi everybody, my name is Dee Burks and this is Retirement Rescue, where we talk about how to make money, save money, and create a retirement from nothing. Well, one of the things I ran across this week is the idea of what makes up a happy retirement. I ran across a study that was done by Merrill Lynch, and they surveyed people who were retired and had been retired at least 2 years. And the things they said were very interesting. So I'm going to talk about the top 5 things on that list in reverse order, because that's just fun. And we'll go into depth on each one. Number 5 on the top 5 secrets is retire earlier and have adventures. One of the regrets people have once they retire is the realization they actually could have done it much sooner. They really could have, and they kept going for another year or two. And the thing is, none of us know how long we have to go out and really enjoy that retirement and enjoy those adventures. So be sure you don't wait too long to actually retire. The last video I did was on semi-retirement. That is a really great solution for a lot of people. It allows you to go ahead and enjoy the benefits of being retired while you're still young enough to really get the most out of them. So don't wait too long to retire. Number 4. Find something to do that gives you purpose and meaning at least 5 hours a week. We've talked about how retirement is a really big life change for people. And we've talked about how you need to create connections and find something to do. A lot of people don't think past, hey, I'm going to retire. They just think, oh, I'll go enjoy life. But they don't really define what that means. People who are really happy in retirement find something to do, whether that be volunteering, working part-time, maybe starting up a little home-based business, but something to do with their time at least 5 hours a week that gives them meaning. That's really important. Finding happiness in retirement is directly connected with feeling useful and meaningful and feeling like that you contribute something. So don't forget, as you are thinking about retirement, or maybe you're already retired, find something to do at least 5 hours a week that gives you that feeling, that wonderful feeling of giving back. Number 3, and this is kind of connected to the last one, but ensure you keep good, strong social contacts and family contacts. It is really easy to get isolated when your life changes and you stop working or you decide to do something completely different from what you've been doing. You can get really isolated quickly. The same is true if you have a spouse die, if you move to a different location. It is really easy to get isolated in retirement. So you've got to focus on getting involved, maybe going to a community center, a senior center, figuring out who your new group of friends are going to be. This is especially true if you have been a couple for decades and suddenly you're not, either through death or divorce even. It's really important to create and sustain those emotional and social contacts that keeps you from getting depressed and definitely adds to your happiness in retirement. Number 2, money. And this one is about focusing on financial independence. It's not about focusing on wealth or how much you do or don't have. Once you retire, it can be very easy to become so concerned that you're gonna run out of money that you don't enjoy anything. And it leads to dramatic unhappiness. That's why it's number 2 on the list. And financial independence isn't about, like I said, a big pile of money. It's about creating a retirement that works. Maybe that's through lowering your expenses and downsizing. That was a big one for me. Maybe it's through part Social Security, part working a little bit, either seasonally or part-time. Maybe it's through income in other ways, like a disability or something of that nature. There are always ways we can hobble together a good financial retirement. Not necessarily a wealthy retirement, but a good, happy, satisfying retirement. And that's what you're going for. It's not about just trying to not spend a dollar. It is about putting together either numerous streams of income or really maximizing your main stream of income so that those worries don't overwhelm you. And the number one thing, of course, you've probably already guessed it, is your health. One of the things none of us knows is how long we have. You have no idea, no matter what age you retire at, how long that retirement's going to be. It may only be a few years if you're unlucky. It may be 30 years if you're lucky. But being able to maintain your health is the number one factor to a happy retirement. That means staying active. Here again, when you feel like you're isolated, it's really easy to get inactive. But staying active keeps you healthy, whether that's through aqua yoga or swimming, running, walking, or like me, I get out, I hike, I fly fish, I do things outdoors. No matter what it is for you, staying active and being sure you maintain your health and take care of any chronic issues, again, it's the number one factor toward being happy. None of us are happy when we're sick. None of us are happy when we have a chronic issue that is very difficult to deal with. None of us are happy when we're in pain. So taking care of those issues, focusing on your health, and ensuring you stay healthy is the number one secret to being happy in retirement. Now, if you've enjoyed this video, please click subscribe, and I'll see you next time.